So the interesting thing for the St. Louis Blues was all the hype surrounding this team heading into the season. Now we look at the standings. They've got just 17 points, and by most people's standards, this team is vastly underperformed.
Yeah, there's no question about it. You look through their lineup, and you just look through the stat page. I mean, all kinds of underperformance. I mean, Jaden Schwartz is a real good player.
I know.
Not getting much done this year. Tarasenko has been okay, but six goals. You're looking for more from him. Petrangelo is a Norris Trophy type defender, and, you know, he's played a little bit better of late, but you can see the numbers there, just 7 points kicking it offensively. Braden Schenn, 10 points. I mean, I know some of these guys have dealt with some injuries, but it hasn't been good. And then Jake Allen has had his ups and downs and, you know, below 900 save percentage with. So there's been a lot of underperformance. And Doug Armstrong mentioned it. He said, hey, this core, they've run out of equity with me. So I would expect the next thing is going to be some guys getting moved out of there.
Yeah. And it's shocking to see where they're at for me, because going into this year and getting Ryan O'Reilly, you're thinking, all right, maybe the
Blues,
I liked them a lot. And Jake Allen's actually picked it up lately, but there's been some, you know, questions with goaltending. Colt Parayko is a guy who you could actually see dominating at a lot of points, but this season he has been, you know, up and down. But there is a good team here, and that's what Craig Berube said. He said, this is a good club, we got to figure it out. But to me, it's not, this season isn't open for them. I could see this group switching it around and getting going, but it's going to have to start with scoring. And, you know, you've seen them get shut out, and you've seen them struggle to just score goals, where you're talking about Tarasenko at 6 goals. I mean, you think of him, you're like, this could be 40, 50 goal guy. I mean, the way that you've seen him play. So the goal scoring just has to pick up, but they have the guys to get it done. It's just going to figure out a way to play with a little bit more pace. They're not the quickest team. They're a little older in a sense of, you know, that they don't skate as fast as some other teams around the NHL. But there still is a lot there to grow and build and end up getting into the playoffs. But it's going to have to happen really quick.
And the question, they've been shut out in 3 of the last 4, so they're not scoring. But the question I've had all year, are they going to embrace the Robert Thomases and the Jordan Kyrous? Are they going to give these guys more ice time? Or, you know, the coach comes in, Craig Berube, he doesn't know. He's clearly the interim coach. Clearly, because Doug Armstrong talked about the idea that, you know, we're going to have a search and maybe we'll find someone else. So for Craig Berube, what's important to him? Winning now, winning games. He would love to, I'm sure, keep that job and be a head coach in this league, which means, do I play those young kids and worry about the mistakes they're going to make, or do I play veteran players who I feel I could trust more? I feel they have to embrace the younger players because that's the way this league is going. We will see what they decide to do.
And we heard Mike Yeo say not too long ago that he expected that he was on the hot seat at that time. He felt the pressure because of the expectations facing this team. I mean, you look at the standings, it's a long climb up.
Yeah, but and the issue is this is the best division in the NHL.
This is the wrong division to start.
Exactly.
Poorly.
Very opposite situation of the Oilers right now.
Yeah, if they're the Pacific, they're like, we're fine. We could win this division.
That's right.
But right now, you're already pretty much looking at them having to get a wild card spot because you can't leapfrog that many teams. There's so many 3-point games where both teams are getting points, so it's going
to
be tough.
You have to get to 5th in that division because most likely the five teams will come out of the Central. Can they get to 5th? We will see. Craig Berube also in his presser today, he talked a lot about the influence that Ken Hitchcock, of all people, had on him. So it was interesting that Ken Hitchcock's name came up a lot today. And the thing I was going to mention before about Hitch, people talk about his love for coaching. He spent the summer with the Kansas City Chiefs. He's very good friends with Andy Reid from his time in Philadelphia. And he watched the way that they work with the NFL players. So Hitch is always, even though he's a 66-year-old man, soon to be 67, he's still one of those guys that's looking to learn, looking to do things differently. So I'll be curious to see if he reinvents himself again now in Edmonton.
And Ken Hitchcock has always been good to us, so congratulations, Ken.
Yeah.
We are very happy for you.